everyone, welcome to week 30 of my Accutane adventures. That's right, you heard it, 30 weeks. You gotta have a lot of patience. This is a long-term treatment of Accutane. It's funny, when I went on Friday to see my dermatologist, I got two different doctors were like, hey man, are you going for the longest treatment ever on Accutane? You going for a Guinness World Record for someone who's on Accutane? Of course, jokingly, it wasn't a mean thing, it was funny. But anyways, me and my dermatologist talked, and I was taking 80 milligrams at night with a meal of fat, right? And we wanted to see if that would help, and it helped a little bit, but what I suggested, I was like, hey, I think that I should up my dosage of Accutane. And he's like, okay, I agree with that. So now we're doing 100 milligrams a day instead of 80 milligrams a day, and I'm doing 40 in the morning or in the afternoon, and then the rest of it 60 at night with my last meal. And hopefully bumping this up a little bit will help me absorb a little bit more of the vitamin A from the Accutane, and also it's helping me dry up a bit. I didn't put moisturizer on this morning, just so you guys could see the difference, see that my face is starting to dry up, my lips are chapping up a lot more, and my eyes are even drying up. So I'm hoping, and what I'm thinking is that because we've upped the dosage, we'll see more of an effect over the next 4 weeks until I go to see my doctor again, and hopefully we'll see me start clearing up a little bit more. But I actually feel like I have started clearing up a lot more. I still have these two patches right here of like, you know, acne and cysts, and a little bit up here on my forehead, but I feel like I'm clearing up from my chin, and I feel like I'm clearing up from the outsides of my temples, and it's migrating in to meet me in the middle, and then hopefully my cheeks will clear up. So here is the close-up. Here it comes. You ready? Prepare yourself. Like I said, I feel like I'm clearing up a lot in my chin area and the tops of my temples, and I see a lot of the blackheads coming out, which is really nice. Without me even touching them or doing anything, I just look at my skin and I'm like, oh, whoa, where'd all the blackheads go at the bottom of my chin? That's awesome. So now I'm gonna move on to my favorite part of these videos, which is answering questions from the comments of last week's video. Now the first question comes from Nicholas, and he says, do you think being on Accutane will affect your genetic potential, your natty limit? In bodybuilding is what he means, in lifting and gaining size. Now, yeah, absolutely. I completely believe that Accutane is going to stop me from making as many gains, as much strength gains, you know, doing the same amount of athletic performance that I would have done without Accutane. Now, I'm not sure if it's going to always stop me, you know, after I get off of it and I be back to normal and I'm at homeostasis again. I don't know if it's gonna stop me from getting to the goals that I wanted to get to. I actually don't think it will at all. I think that I after like maybe a few months of being off Accutane, I'll be right back to where I was as far as making gains, making strength gains, making size gains. But while I'm on Accutane, while you're on Accutane, it is really hard to do the whole bodybuilding thing. Put muscle on, put strength on, while your joints are just dried and you just feel like you aren't as strong and you feel like you can't endure as long. Now I wanted to put this comment up just to prove a point that if you are confident about your acne, if you're confident about yourself and you don't care about your acne, other people won't even notice that you have acne. Now this is just one guy that said this, or girl, I don't know, but I've heard this so many times from people in real life, from people in the comments, from everywhere, that people never noticed my acne. I've talked to girls that I like, you know, and we get into talking and stuff, and then I'm like, oh yeah, like, you know, I'm on Accutane or something, and they're like, oh, you're on Accutane? I never even noticed that you have acne. Like, I never even bothered to care about that. So be confident, that's what I'm saying. I'm just reinforcing that. Be confident, stop caring about your blemishes, just live your life and be happy that you are who you are. And I wanted to put this comment up just because Agatha's been following me forever, and I just wanna say good luck on your journey. I hope the treatment really does you well. I hope you clear up really quickly. I hope you don't have to go as long as I've had to go. And if you have any questions, if you need any support, you have me and you have my entire fan base to ask, to talk to, anything like that. Good luck. Now real quick, Justin Danger wanted me to go over pregnancy and Accutane. Now, this might seem pretty obvious for some people, but you know what? Some people might actually not have any clue about this. When you're on Accutane as a chick, as a woman, a female, you cannot be pregnant. You cannot get into term of pregnancy. You can already be in it. You can't have anything to do with babies. Now they make this super obvious on the packaging here. You'll see they've drawn a normal baby's head, and then they've drawn what could happen to your baby's head if you are pregnant on Accutane. Also, they have all these little warning signs and stuff where it's like, you know, don't be pregnant. Don't be pregnant. You can't be pregnant. Don't do it. And when you actually start Accutane, as a girl, you have to go in there not only for blood tests, but you have to go in there and get your pregnancy checked just to make sure that you're not having a kid, because it's just detrimental to your kid's health if you're on Accutane. Okay, so that's the episode for this week. Hopefully, because we've upped the dosage a little bit, by next week we'll see some more changes even, because I feel like I've seen changes even after 3 or 4 days of upping the dose. But maybe after a week or so, we'll start seeing my face just really drying up. I am having a little bit of back pain, so that's good news, you know, a little bit of side effects. My face is getting a little bit more dry. So hopefully by next week, we'll have a little bit more news. And then in 2, 3, 4 weeks, maybe we'll be a little bit more clear. And who knows, maybe I could be on the cover of a magazine soon. If you feel like supporting the channel, go ahead and check out beyondtheweek.com, get a tank. There's a new design coming out this week or next week, so keep your eyes out peeled for that. And thank you guys so much for checking out my video, supporting me throughout my entire journey, even though it's been long. You guys have been there the entire time, and it seriously has helped me throughout my 30 weeks. And you know I'm gonna be on it for another at least 10, so I'm just stoked that I have you guys to count on to support me. Thank you guys for checking out the video. Team Beyond the Week, let's have your time, MIRIN. I'll see you next week.